In this video, I will share a simple four-step process for buying foreclosed properties. Welcome to the Dealmaker channel. I'm Ronald Cagape. I'm the author of No Money Down Formula in Real Estate, the book that shows you how to buy and sell properties with little or no cash. You can also apply the principles that I discussed in this book on how to buy foreclosed properties. Now, I'm answering this question in response to a message from Melvir Fernandez, one of my followers in Facebook. So he asked me, "Hi, Sir Ronald. Good day po. Ask ko lang po if it's okay to buy foreclosed property with occupant. Paano po kaya ang negotiation po doon? May mga pointers po ba kayo na may sasuggest when it comes sa pagbili ng foreclosed properties?" Alright, the message is a bit longer, but I will answer your question, Melvir. Okay, so in this video, we will talk about how to buy foreclosed properties. And my suggestion is that you have a four-step process. Now, whether it's foreclosed properties or other properties, maybe properties from a developer or properties being sold by a broker or a for sale by owner property, you need to follow the same process. Okay, so this is the simple four-step process that I will give to you. First one is to, of course, find a property. Okay, so because we're talking about bank foreclosed listings, so find one in bank foreclosed property listings. So take the time to visit the banks one by one. Okay, ask for their foreclosed property listings. That's what we did in the past. Now it's a bit more convenient because you can just go to their website and then download their list of foreclosed properties. Of course, I would suggest that you also call them up because sometimes these lists are not updated. Okay. You can also visit my friend Jay Castillo's website, foreclosurephilippines.com. When you visit foreclosurephilippines.com, there is a database of foreclosed property listings already in the website. Okay, so you can see all the foreclosed property listings in one place. Okay, now once you have a list, I suggest that you just focus in one area first. Okay, focus in maybe in Manila or Makati or wherever you are located, like wherever your home is or wherever you work. If you work in Makati, you can look at properties in Makati. If you live in Quezon City, look at properties in Quezon City. Okay, so just focus on one area first. Get all the property listings in that area and then start to visit them one by one. And when you find one property that you like, then the next step is to investigate the property. Okay, so you need to do your due diligence. So that's what you do when you investigate a property. You look at the property, look at the location, you look at the condition. Okay, so you look at every detail. Okay, and especially, as Melvir asked, ask the bank or find out if there is an occupant. Okay, if the previous owner is still living in the property, I suggest that you ask the bank if they will evict the former owner. Okay, so if they will evict the occupant. Because if not, that's going to be a big problem. If you're just starting out, it may be difficult for you to evict a tenant or evict an occupant. So I would suggest that you ask the bank to do it for you. So don't pay them in full. Okay, don't pay them in full until they kick out the tenant. Or that will be the basis of your negotiation, which is step three. Okay, when you negotiate with a bank, don't be afraid to negotiate the price and payment terms. Okay, most banks will listen to any reasonable offer. Of course, if their policy is to not listen to offers below their asking price, then you just have to live with it. Or you can always look at other properties. Okay, so you don't have to be tied to one property or one bank. You have the freedom to check other properties and other sellers, but also exercise the freedom to negotiate the price and terms. Don't be afraid to offer a lower price don't be afraid to ask for payment terms that are advantageous for you. Okay, so what kind of payment terms? Maybe you could ask for 0% or 5% or 10%. I wouldn't put my hopes up right now when you're negotiating with banks to say 0% down payment, but I think you can get away with around 10% down payment. Again, that depends on each bank. Each bank has a different acceptable payment terms. So just go ahead and talk to each bank individually. Okay? Now, once you have negotiated the price and the terms and they're already agreeable to those terms and the bank has also agreed to it, then it's time to close the deal. Okay, so make the formal offer, or if you already have made a formal offer and they have accepted it, then make your earnest money or pay the down payment already. So once you've done all the work of investigating and negotiating, then what you need to do is to seal the deal as soon as possible, because you don't want another person, you know, coming in, giving a higher offer, and then, you know, wasting all of the work that you put in to the property. Okay, so those are the simple four steps in buying any property, really, not just foreclosed properties. So you find a property, you look at different available listings, then you investigate the ones that you like. Okay, if it's all clear, if there are no problems, then you start to negotiate. Okay, or maybe even if there are problems, then that will be even better for you. Okay, so negotiate. And then finally, once you have reached an agreement, don't be afraid to seal the deal. Okay, pull the trigger. Now, one of the questions that you may be asking is, well, how much money is involved in buying real estate? Right? Or how will you pay for it? Okay, so there are three ways. Now, there are three ways that you can pay for any property that you will buy. Okay, so the first one is to pay in cash. So if you have the cash, if you have saved enough money to buy a property, then this is the best way. Okay, the best way to buy any property is to pay cash, because that's how you can ask for maximum discounts. Okay, so you can ask for 10-20% discount, because you can tell them that, hey, I am paying cash anyway. If we are in a situation that, you know, when you're watching this video and it so happens that the market crashed, then paying in cash is even much better, because you can even ask for higher discounts. Now, not everyone can pay cash, of course. So the second method or the second way to pay for a property is to pay on installment. Okay, you can give a small down payment first, like 5%, 10%, 20%. Again, that depends on the bank and that depends on your capacity. Again, the more that you can afford, the better, because you have more leeway when you are negotiating. Okay. Even though I wrote the book, No Money Down Formula, okay, No Money Down Formula just allows you to buy properties from specific sellers. Okay. So from specific sellers, you can buy with 0% down. Okay. But for most sellers, they would ask for at least 10-20% down payment. And even most of them, in fact, would ask for 30% down payment. So think of it as a long-term investment. You should be buying properties anyway. Okay, so when you, for example here, when you pay on installment, a sample payment plan could be, you know, 10 to 30% down payment, and then the 70 to 90% balance, depending on how much down payment you give, is payable over X number of years. Okay, so there is an interest rate that will be tacked onto that. And you may be asking, do banks do this? Well, not all banks. There are only a few banks that do this. The advantage of paying on installment is the bank that allows this will, first of all, will not consider it a mortgage. So it's not a loan. It's not a loan. It's a contract to sell agreement. What that means is the title will not be transferred to you. There will be no annotation of a mortgage on the title. The bank will keep the title to themselves. Okay, so this is installment payment plan. Okay, now most people could probably already afford this. And just to give you an idea of how much you need to, I guess, save up or prepare for. Okay, so let's have an example. For example, if you're buying a 1 million peso property at 20% down payment and in 15 years to pay at 12% interest. Okay, 12% interest is what some of the banks that are offering this payment scheme are now offering. Okay, so at a down payment of 20%, then you need 200,000 pesos. Okay, so that has to be ready already. Then the balance of 800,000 will be payable over 15 years. Okay, and that will amount to a monthly amortization of 9,601 peso and 34 centavos. About 99,600. So you can just look at the numbers on my side here. Okay. So if the property is, say, 2 million, and if you're going to buy it using the same terms, then you just double the amounts needed. So you will need 400,000 and you'll be paying around 19,000. Okay, 19,000 per month. Okay, so that is the rough ballpark figure when you're buying a property worth 1 million. Okay? Now, the next way, okay, if you cannot if this seems too high for you, let's say, I can't afford the monthly amortization. You know, we can't get away from the down payment, but maybe you can say, you know, Ron, I can't afford that monthly amortization. That's too high for a 1 million peso property. Then maybe you should consider getting bank financing. Okay, so the third way to buy a property would be to pay with bank financing or pay with financing. It could be from the bank or it could be from Pag-ibig. Okay, so whatever, you know, financing institution that you can I guess get money from, okay, then this will be the way for you to afford your first investment property. And many financing institutions would allow most financing institutions would actually ask for 20-30% equity. However, you can actually get a bank or a Pag-ibig to pay 100% of the purchase price. Okay, now the secret to that I put in the book, how in my book, No Money Down Formula in Real Estate. But I'll also, don't worry, I'll talk about it in a future video. Just so make sure to be subscribed to this channel to wait for that video. Okay, but again, you can actually get the bank to pay 100% okay, of the property's value. But let's just say that for now, we're doing the same thing. You know, we're just paying 20%. Okay, we're paying 20% down for the same property. Okay, same 1 million peso property. 20% down payment, 15 years to pay, but this time the interest rate is 6%. So that is the advantage when you are buying from a financing institution. Okay, you're not buying from the bank on installment basis. You're using financing because the rates are usually lower. Okay, so this is what happens. Down payment is still 200,000, but the monthly amortization is 6,750. Okay, so that is a huge drop. That's almost 3,000 pesos per month saved on monthly amortization. So if you are actually paying for your house right now, and check your interest rate. If your interest rate is high, take this as an opportunity to buy, to refinance your housing loan, because the lower your interest rate, the lower your monthly amortization. But I'm moving to another topic. That is how you pay. Now, that is how you can afford to buy your real estate investment. Okay? So again, follow the four-step process. Find a property. Investigate. Do your due diligence. And then once you're satisfied with the due diligence, negotiate. Okay, negotiate for the price and terms of the property, and then close the deal. Okay, so go find some amazing deals. There's always an amazing deal every week. Okay, you just need to go out there and look for them. And actually, the question is, it's really not a question of is there a good deal to find out there. There are hundreds of good deals out there. The question is, will you be the one closing those deals? All right. Now I have a question for you. What is your question when it comes to buying foreclosed properties? So let me know in the comment section below. Also, I am doing a survey. Okay, I'm doing a survey of real estate investors on what kind of questions do you want answered, okay, in real estate. What are the things that you want to know about real estate? So please go to this link, or go to the link on my left side. That's, or you can also check out the link in the description of the video below. Okay, so please take the time to answer that survey. It's a quick survey, just 10 minutes of your time. All right, so if you like this video, please press the like button and then subscribe. Okay, also you can share this to a friend whom you know is interested in real estate investing. Okay, and please make sure to subscribe to this channel to get more real estate tips. This is Ronald Kagape encouraging you to make deals and grow rich.